Club Mail.
Too comfortable, serve them at Lunchables for three and their abdominal. I'm back with some attitude, yeah, better show some gratitude. Ain't don't feel uncomfortable, cold front east for you. Thermoscope deep for you, silencer whisper through. Line you up, you the target, one shot kissing you. Your wife, the kids, the pets, they all miss you. Your mom, sis, cousin said it wasn't meant for you. Every dog had this day, don't shit where I lay. I'm lying, yeah, you violate, I'm MIA. Icon, A5, my getaway. I'm on the water above the clouds, the cush way. So fuck the he say, no Prince DNA. Gonna check my bottom, bitch, sexy as some lingerie. 2010, M-A-C-K, Mr. P-A-R-K, ass chick, come on. Don't ask me what to do, I'm on a different status. Young, black, and dangerous, I don't pay no taxes. I don't play by the rules, kill them off in masses. Kings County's where I'm from, your bitch love my accent. Flatbush, Bed-Stuy, always known for action. Shit's no relaxing, I'm always on my feet, or rather on the go. My favorite word is peace, and I ain't talking treaty. My niggas play for keeps. I'm Z-Set, motherfucker, we don't cop no please. You see the similar in the air, your heart start to freeze. I transform, I'm like good stuff to please me. I wanna rock right now, we ain't homies. Fuck what you came for, you getting what I got for you. The spot, I'm rerouting you. Now you in the danger zone, no cops to the rescue. I'm out with my icon. Icon.
International zone, because I'm known by not blasting that chrome. But we all get stupid, that means I break shit. Pizza ain't even known for all that fake shit. Cause we be winners, y'all be losers. Cats better duck and hide from my shooters. Ladies love me, the women adore us. That's why these bitches be trying to get on my toe. But not the way that I pop, let it blow. My team gon' ride when it's time to go. To just know I'm a
ladies and gentlemen, know. Welcome to another episode of Words with Pude and
Plaga. Sometimes you
and you
and you
and you
and you.
Yeah, we back in the building.
What's again. Good, y'all? It's Monday night, raining in NYC. How y'all feeling out there, people? We back, season 2, episode 3.
You're already snow. And ladies and gentlemen, be clear. It's going to get better and better and better and better. Trust and believe. You heard what I'm telling you. You heard
we
what I'm telling
you? Got some things y'all, things in store for y'all for season 2 coming up, you know. But what we got going on? Oh, yeah, we got sports back. Oh, shit. We got sports back. Basketball for the fellas, you know.
I mean, sports been back.
I won't say sports. I'll just say basketball.
Basketball.
Fuck it.
Basketball.
You know niggas love some motherfucking basketball.
For sure.
For sure. You understand? You know, they say that the Lakers going for the chip this year. I don't know.
Yeah, you's a hater. And I'm so happy you's a hater because what did your boy...
No, I don't fuck with
yo,
Lakers.
Check this out. And I hope M. God is watching. I hope M. God, a.k.a. Muff Dog. I hope Muff Dog is watching right now. Okay. What are you at? 35, almost 40 last night?
And they lost last night?
And a loss?
And a loss.
Now, you got to...
It was a light loss.
Nah, it wasn't a light loss. That was a heavy loss.
Heavy loss.
You know why that was a heavy loss?
Why?
Don't talk to me about my Lakers. That was a heavy loss. They didn't have one player out on the court that was above 7 feet at all. Broke Lopez? Yeah. He was doing his thing. I give it to him. He was doing his thing. He like... Harden on me in a pose. are you crazy? Are you crazy? Are you freaking crazy? I'm taking him. Little baby hook, little teardrop. All this. Oh, you know what Giannis remind me of? Because we just had a conversation about your guy Giannis.
Yeah. What about him? What about him?
He does what LeBron used to do when he was young. All he do is go downhill. And when he go downhill...
His first shot in the game was a three-pointer.
I mean, listen, he made 2 threes. Let's be clear.
But that was his first shot. He just came
out. I mean, listen.
He's going to get better.
Listen.
He's young, man. He's going to be better than him.
Listen, I'm not saying...
He was better than
listen,
him. Listen,
I'm not saying what he's going to be. I'm talking about what he is 2020 right now. And right now, y'all giving him the crown over LeBron.
You still believe LeBron James I'm telling you, is the best of the game now?
What I'm trying to...
I'm asking you.
I'm telling you something.
You think that he's the best? You think that he's better than Giannis right now?
I think LeBron, to me...
Right now. You think he's better than Giannis right now?
Yeah.
What?
Yeah, I do. And the reason why, it's not like I see Giannis hit like 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 6.
I think he's better.
3-pointers in a game. I don't see him hitting mad threes. Cause you was talking about. Hold on. Let me just get to it. Cause guess what? If you was watching the game yesterday?
Yeah.
What did D'Antoni say? D'Antoni said, he hit the three. We giving him the shot.
No, I said they're giving it to him.
What we not giving you is that lane.
That lane.
Because that's where you go crazy. But I'm getting into that because you was like, LeBron shot. LeBron shot. LeBron's in his 17th year.
That's why his shot should be superb.
No, his in his
17th. Shot should be like listen, money. Like the old head listen, on listen, the court who come listen, and smoke you. You smoke got, your boots listen, with a J. You're supposed to be smoking these young boys' boots with that J like Mike was.
Yo, Facebook. Listen,
I'm a
Facebook.
Mike. I'm from the Mike era.
Make sure y'all leave your comments and all that, cause in 15 minutes after we talk about this, we're gonna look at the comments and then address the comments.
Yeah, we're gonna address y'all.
If you wanna chime in, you can chime in all night. We're gonna be looking at it periodically. Yeah. We don't really wanna move the cameras and shit like that.
You know
but,
me. You,
but,
you know I
that's
don't.
Bullshit. What he's
man,
talking about?
Come on,
I'm
man.
Talking about. Listen, you so, have to tell me what player in a 17th season. Y'all comparing the OG to the young blood, and the OG still holding
saying,
his own.
They saying he the best.
That's
in
what
the
I'm
league
saying.
Still, he's not.
I mean, he's the best.
Not the number one guy. Listen, he's one of listen, the best in
yo,
the league.
Let me tell you
but
something.
He's not the number one guy
let me,
no more.
Let me ask you something.
He's
right?
not even if, on his own team.
If Plaga was in the game, right? And when Plaga came out the gates, it was crazy. He's doing his numbers crazy, dropping 30 whenever he want, crazy, right? Plaga's in his 17th season now. What you want Giannis to do or what you see Giannis doing, LBJ done did it. He done did it. You want me to keep repeating? No.
Yeah,
no. I did what he did already.
I hear you.
I did it.
I'm
in my seventh.
Sound like excuses.
It's not excuses. You got to tell me a better NBA player.
Like
you got no. You gotta tell me a better NBA player in a 17th season.
I want him
season.
To do what they say.
You feel me?
They say
Jordan. It. Jordan did. And I brought this up when we wasn't even talking on camera the other day. I said, "Yo, Jordan didn't play 17 seasons, and the seasons that he played after he did his six, and then he came back. Wash me up. Wash me up in the cycle. Wash me up. He was
talking
washed.
About the Wizards. You're talking about the Wizards.
When he came back after the six. You feel me? After he went on the championship run.
Yeah, but LeBron don't even got
and
six.
And he came back. No, we're not talking about. No, we're not talking about six. What LeBron had.
That's what I'm talking about.
No,
though.
No, no. You're switching the narrative. We're not talking about what LeBron had. I'm asking you.
Them.
Because you see, this is where they fall wrong, man.
Right.
They want to compare someone in their 10th season or their 11th or 12th. Or third, or fifth, or
that's,
sixth.
You know that's the game, though, bro.
No, that's you.
That's the game. That's because, not me. That's the game.
No, that's you because niggas still.
Because
listen,
you.
Right now, in his 17th season.
You the
guess
best
what?
Niggas gonna
guess
come
what,
for you.
Guess what, though? Guess what?
Niggas gonna
it's
come for
you. It's the 17th season. And
game,
who is
man.
The
it's
two front runners? It's not. It's you.
It's not me.
Who's the two front runners for the MVP? LeBron. And Giannis.
And Giannis.
It's not LeBron, Giannis, and da-da-da, and KD, and AD, and this one, and Harden, and blah-blah-blah. No, 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 no. The MVP in LeBron James' 17th season. You got to tell me an NBA player in their 17th season even mention for MVP. I'm waiting.
I can't tell you what.
Because there is none.
So then what?
Because there is none.
Then
so
what?
So respect what he's doing in his 17th.
Who said that?
You gotta. You. I want to know if.
Who
first of all, I want to know if Giannis is even gonna go 17 seasons. That's number one. That's number one.
That remains to be seen.
That's number one. So what LeBron is doing right now, currently in his 17th season, incredible. Incredible. Don't talk to me. Incredible. That's why
he loves the Lakers.
That's football. Why he's MVP.
Lakers.
That's why.
He's a Lakers fan.
That's why. But still, y'all know that.
Get out of here.
Y'all know that.
He's a Lakers fan. Get out of here.
Yeah, M-E-Z.
Get
yeah,
out of here.
M-E-Z.
Get
what?
Out of here with that. Pooh.
What?
He's a
don't rep the Lakers when we get our chip, M-E-Z.
Yeah. Yeah.
Don't do it.
Oh.
Don't do it.
Yeah, I hope he's watching.
What's up, Sha? I see you, Sha, a.k.a. Kobe Twin. Rest yeah. in peace to Black Mamba.
I see they a Lakers lover.
Black Mamba.
That's why
he's
talking like that. Niggas just want to see LeBron win a little sneaky chip.
I don't want to see LeBron
this
win
bum
anything.
Ass, this bum ass.
I just want my Lakers to
restart
win.
Season. What the? Restart the whole
I don't
want to
hear nothing about the restart because everybody's a part of it.
Yeah, everybody's a part
they
of it.
They could have opt out. Everybody's a part of it, so they feel they got a chance. Okay.
Part of it.
Okay. Because it was our season anyway.
Anywho.
No, ain't no anywho.
Anywho.
Anywho what?
I don't see him looking.
Anywho good. What?
This is what I'm talking about.
What are you talking about?
Niggas be talking about, all right.
No, what you talking about? Not fuck
this
what niggas
what
talking,
I'm
about.
Talking about.
What you talking about?
I'm talking about because I watched it.
Me too. You watched
it. Sportscasters.
What you talking about?
I watched the Sportscasters.
Anywho. What you talking about?
I watched the people talk about it all day, right?
Anywho.
Numbers, right? And they say numbers never lie, right? So that's what they base everything on.
Yeah, and your boy Giannis had 35 with a loss. Numbers don't lie.
That happened.
And nobody on the opposite team was 7 feet.
So that means what?
That means y'all Basuda, bro.
That means they Basuda?
That means y'all Basuda. Why Giannis? I didn't see no post moves from Giannis. I didn't see any. All I seen last night was him going downhill. What? I didn't see no dunking moves. I didn't see no. Got no post moves. His jump shot is 50-50. All he do is go downhill.
So LeBron,
gotta step it up.
LeBron is the best in the league still then, right? That's what you're saying. I asked you that question earlier.
Right now, I would have to say yes.
Okay.
Yeah.
Right.
Yeah, of course.
So how he start off the first quarter, was it?
I keep trying to tell you.
The fuck is numbers?
See,
I forgot the numbers.
See,
but how do you start off like that?
Yo, your math.
How the best start off?
Your math.
How the best start out?
I'm gonna tell you right
passing.
Now.
How the
easy.
Best don't wanna? How the best make a little lucky
don't call nothing
rebound?
Luck. Practice.
Come on,
practice,
man. That wasn't
and
no.
Skills.
He missed the main shot.
Hey, and he followed up. Do it. How you letting a 17th season old nigga ass nigga miss his shot and get his rebound?
Because this new NBA is weak.
Nah, that the new NBA is
he
weak.
Soft.
So. Now the new NBA is weak, y'all.
That's right.
How you let a 17-year-old vet miss his shot and get the rebound?
Yo,
all y'all young bloods out
spoiled.
There.
No, hey,
how you do that?
I'm spoiled. I come from the Mike days. Mike, watching after watching the fucking Last Dance, after watching that motherfucking Last Dance.
Ladies and gentlemen, he just watched the Last Dance. Everybody,
get
at him.
Get at my goofy,
whatever. He just watched the Last Dance last week. So don't talk to me.
I just finished watching the Last Dance.
That shit is mad. We done already got the vibe, felt it. You know what I'm saying? Went outside on the court, took a couple shots.
Besides that, I was witnessing that. It's not like I was seeing those games and stuff while that was really going on.
I mean, that is true.
But watching it from that perspective, watching the Last Dance.
From Mike's perspective?
From Mike's perspective.
Yeah.
And realizing, all right, me labeling him as the GOAT. There's nobody like Mike. And I say, if y'all going to compare somebody, right, like LeBron, he is great in his own right.
He's not Mike.
But he ain't no Mike. He's not coming out there with that killer instinct every game.
First of
all, and I don't want to hear that, especially right now.
In his 17th season,
he looked like he taking too much time to think. It's too much. What's going on? Mike is still trying to kill.
Not in his 17th
season.
He's
trying to get a ring this year?
Not in his 17th season.
Come on, man.
He's getting a ring. Listen, Kawhi Leonard, with your...
You got to know when to gracefully bow out. And I
what
think this
the
is
hell?
It. We want to play till his son comes.
Listen, you gracefully bow out when you can't.
Gracefully bow
listen,
out.
When you,
I don't want you to be no assist man. I don't want to see LeBron assist all game.
Let me stop you right now in this track.
Weak.
Let me stop you right now in your tracks.
I don't know.
Let me stop you right now in your tracks.
Weak.
It's not weak.
It's weak.
First of all,
care about the.
Let me ask you a question. Your math.
Cool for the stats.
I know you don't answer.
I don't
want to
see my best player.
I gotta say your math.
Come on.
Your math.
Out of here. It's weak.
When you get,
him,
hold
Mike.
On. Let me ask you something, Plaga, right now. Right? Say, boom. You 40, right? Say you 40 years old. Say you 40 years old, right?
He not 40.
No, chill out. Chill out. Say you 40 years old.
He ain't 40.
Right? And no, I'm saying, say you 40 years old, right? And you get on the court with a 57-year-old, right? Game 20.
No 57-year-olds in the league. So
no, I'm just talking about. I'm giving you the analogy. No, LeBron is the oldest
no
in the league.
No, he ain't the oldest.
I'm talking about as 17 years,
he's
not
the
as age. Consistently
league.
Playing LeBron James 17 years. Consistently playing, not all for a year, and the team come pick you up.
Vince Carter was just the one.
I mean,
VC.
VC, and guess what? He's even a better example. He still was given. I gotta look at his stats, but he was giving niggas at least 15.
VC.
So you should be the same as yourself if you're 20 and you can't pull 15 in the league. That's what I'm saying. But besides VC, and VC wasn't even doing that on a level as LeBron. Later in his career, he'll hit a couple shots. He'll do this. He'll come and motivate. Yeah, but he's still not doing what LeBron is doing in his 17th. He's not. And I told Plaga, I said, yo, check this out. If I'm playing, and I'm just giving 17 because that's 17 years older. So if I'm playing with one of these dudes that just came in the league or one of these dudes that came in the league maybe 5 years after me or 3 years after me or whatever the case may be, I'm in my 17th season. I told Plaga, I don't care at this point how LeBron gets his over 20.
You don't care how he get the 20.
I don't care. I don't care if it's jump shots.
You don't care how
I don't
get
care
the 20
if it's free
points.
Listen,
as long
I don't
as
care.
He get it, right?
I don't care if it's free throws. Yeah, because he's not chucking. He's getting his assists, and he's still gonna give you over 20.
I'm saying.
You feel me?
That's your team, so I expect you to. You know
what I mean?
That's your team.
But
respect your team. I respect LeBron for a lot of other more things. You know, I've never been a LeBron fan.
I respect him for
the court.
I respect LeBron what he do off the court,
you know,
first and foremost.
I do.
I'm a Lakers fan, and LeBron came to my team.
He's a big voice.
I was never a LeBron fan.
In the movement right now.
I'm a Kobe fan. Yeah. Don't ever forget it.
Yeah, you a Kobe head.
Stop it.
Yeah, that's what I'm
Stop
saying.
Stop it. Rest in peace, the Black Mamba. Stop. I'm not a LeBron fan. Don't ever get it twisted. I'm not a LeBron fan. LeBron came to my team.
Hey, you a Lakers fan. Fuck out of here.
Do not. He came to my team.
Fucking
and
Lakers.
My team is winning it. Facts.
Everybody got their money on the Lakers this year.
You don't.
Nope.
Exactly. So that's easy.
I don't. That's easy money for me. They ain't winning this fucking chip. Fuck that.
Yeah. You're going to be broke around these times when the chip come around.
They ain't winning the
chip. I bet you don't take no bets against the Lakers. I bet you take no
I'm gonna take bets. What are you talking about? It's easy money.
They gotta beat Toronto. Toronto's the defending champs. They just beat my guys. So I wanna see what they do against Toronto. They gotta beat Toronto to get out of there. You know what I mean? So we'll see.
They gotta beat the Clippers to get out the fucking West. What you talking about?
We beat the Clippers back to back.
Okay.
We beat them before the COVID, and then when we came back, we thrashed them again.
I hear ya.
All right. So then what you talking about? Why are you talking about the Clippers to me then?
Sounds excellent.
We took care of them. We only meet them 4 times. We took care of them.
Sounds excellent.
It's a done deal.
But yo, on another note, we're gonna switch the subject real quick, you know. Sports is back. We appreciate that, though. Appreciate all the players that supporting the movement right now that's going on in the world, taking their little time out.
Facts. I appreciate that on the back.
Those that put the jersey.
Lives Matter, equality.
I see some of you players chose, I'm going to just say this real quick, that chose not to put whatever on your jersey. It's like, yo, this.
I don't care about those players because guess what? Those players don't stand
Harden
for anything.
Harden is one that's included. Harden.
Niggas don't stand for nothing.
You're a bird, Harden. Because you see all your other brothers, like, it's camaraderie.
I don't even care about like, watch face.
But I
appreciate
all
individuals.
All skin folk ain't kin folk.
Exactly. So why you mad?
Nah, I just wanted to be clear, though.
Yeah, don't be mad.
It's like the homeboy.
Don't be mad.
And nobody don't wish no injuries on nobody. Son from Orlando. Damn, I can't call his name. But he blew his knee out.
Oh, I seen him.
Blew that knee out, ACL. You know, tore the ACL. He said he didn't want to participate because Jesus, he's a Christian and Jesus doesn't, whatever. You see how that, you see how karma work quick sometimes? Because that doesn't only sound right, bro. Just say you don't want to participate. But look, you go out there, now you're going to want these same players to support you throughout your injury. You're going to want these same people to support you throughout your injury, right? So shout out to all the players that participated.
Nah.
Facts. But you had your boy. You had your boy on another though. You had your boy 6ix9ine in the hood shooting videos the other day. Shit first crazy.
First and foremost, watch your mouth. Your boy.
Your boy.
Your boy 6ix9ine. Your boy.
Your boy.
Not my boy.
Your boy Big 6ix9ine.
Your boy 6ix9ine was out there wilding in the hood. But listen, what I told you.
He off house arrest now. He shoot videos.
Listen, man.
He got goons in the videos.
I'm so happy that you brought this up right now because we had conversations.
He can't come outside. It was
listen,
a lot of
listen,
talks.
Listen.
He can't
listen,
come
listen.
Out.
Listen.
I don't care when he come out.
Listen, man.
Yeah.
Listen.
He came outside.
It's just like
he was in the hood too.
Listen, bro. Listen, man.
I mean, I ain't no
capping. You can't be capping when the video been out for 24 hours and got 2 million views. So you're not capping a damn thing. Mm-hmm. What I'm saying is that.
No cap.
What I'm saying is that what the game has changed and it's totally changed. Mm-hmm. And it's never going to go back to what it was.
So what you mean, you know, what you mean you know, by that? You know, what you mean
you know,
by that?
Be, you know,
be specific.
I am. You know when they be like, fashion or your parents or if you're still lucky to have your grandparents around or whatever the case may be, older people in your family, they'll let you know that, oh yeah, that style was out certain such and such and such.
Time,
but
yeah.
You know, when you do your own history, you see that, yeah, styles come back around, they come back around, like niggas been dead, right? Okay. Now, with Tekashi, we already then predicted that he was gonna do numbers. We already predicted that when he leave them, I told you already, him being Spanish and him having that link with his peoples, he always could be with his peoples. You understand what I'm saying? At the end of the day, he got into a situation, and like I told you, I was like, yo, bro, he's still going to be able to fall back on his kinfolk. Why? I remember when he was out before he snitched and all of that, and they were showing videos of him in the hood passing out bread to all the old people and this and that and that and this, like looking out for his hood where he was at in Bushwick and things of that nature. Mm-hmm. So you got to understand that once he got back with his people, that it was going to be on and popping. And this goes back to what I was telling you last week. Some people be saying things for clout. You feel what I'm saying? If you're willing to take Tekashi out right now, that means you're willing to go to jail for life, for a body. Period. Period.
Nah, that's a fact. I don't disagree.
Period. The close case, the end. It's so many things that happen out here that people have not addressed. And that's why I told you I was like, yo, hip hop on which it stood for and which we thought it was coming up is different. It's totally different. It's a whole new era. It's evolved into some straight entertainment.
It's straight entertainment.
Listen, it's straight entertainment. But meaning that you could be a guy that never came outside, not to cut you off. You could be a guy that never came outside at all, was downstairs in your basement or in your room in your crib, and you came up with a gimmick and you're online and you got a million followers and now you're getting money and now you start acting crazy. You understand what I'm saying? As you can see, him having 2 million views, listen, dudes that rap hard bodies, spit verbs and nouns and adjectives, right? Got a following, right? They still not doing numbers like Tekashi within 24 hours. Period.
It's that controversy.
Period. It's not even the controversy. It's a different era. All of that shit about you being this and being that, motherfuckers don't give a fuck about none of that. See, back in the days, a lot of shit you had to do to earn. You understand what I'm saying? They could identify you easily. If you was out there with the BMWs, with the BBs, yeah, oh, that nigga getting money. He hustling. He got to be hustling to a sudden, or he got a good job. Either or. You feel what I'm saying? Now, niggas bust checks, niggas do this, niggas do that, blah, 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 came this, came that, blah, 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 blah. Now, you can't even tell, you got to run down or a nigga, you know what I'm saying? You got to know. Because now, money, you know, money's power. Money's always going to be power. Because not everyone has money. That's why money's power, because not everyone has money. So if I say to you, $50,000 might not be nothing to me. I spend that on wardrobe. In a day. And I'm like, yo, my nigga, I don't like that nigga. I give you 50. Nigga, you ain't make 50 in the last 4 or 5 years. Matter of fact, you never made 50 in a year. What you gonna do? Let me get that 50. And you gonna do it. Tekashi got money. Tekashi always gonna have people behind him because he got money. He knows at this point who's real, he should know at this point who's real friends and who's this and who's that and who's this and who's that. You feel what I'm saying? Now I'm just paying everybody. That's it. And they can't stop him. And as you can see, the public support him, because if you get 2 million views less than 24 hours and you're an established rapper that never snitch and spit in bars, and it takes you 6 months to hit the 2 million, or it takes a month depending on the artist, or 2 weeks depending on the artist, because I want to be fair. Tekashi is doing this shit in 24 hours. In 24 hours.
This new era.
He's getting paid from YouTube. He's getting paid. Nobody's doing nothing unless you're willing to go to jail. Now, why is it okay if Jay-Z continued to do business with a known informant? Why is that okay?
I don't
tell me that. Why is that? Why is nobody? Why is nobody? Why is nobody keep putting the foot on the neck with that type of situation? Because that's real. It's documented. It's nothing that I'm making up. It was on front of the Post, in front of the Times, in front of the Daily News. It's on every blog, everywhere you go. You seen it when it happened. But you feel me? Listen, ladies and gentlemen. Sometimes silence is your best defense. Ladies and gentlemen, let me repeat that. Sometimes, because I know a lot of people, y'all ain't into the internet, y'all got sometimes, silence is the key. Because guess what? Through all of this, did you hear anything from Jay about it? Do you hear anybody talking about it today?
No.
So what has happened? They brought it up. He didn't address it. It's all facts and true. It's not a lie. They didn't lie on him. It's true. He haven't said a word. And since he haven't said a word, sometimes when you don't say a word, you don't give the narrative for a back and forth. So you just have to wait till whatever the person said die down. You understand what I'm saying? It's so much shit going on in the world right now, and human beings' attention span is so short. It's so short.
Yeah, nobody's really.
All I have to do is not say anything.
Because none of it was.
Because by the end of the week, it's so much shit going on by the end of the week. I didn't feed into that. That's a dead story. For those that's looking for that, I'm not looking for that. I'm focused. I'm paying attention. You haven't said anything. And this is all facts. What's up with that? You feel me? Like, if you don't snitch, but you fuck with a snitch hard body, what that makes you? That's all I want to know. If you don't snitch, but you fuck with a snitch hard body, what that makes you? You telling me, Trub, you credible? If you fuck with a snitch, I'm like, damn, I can't tell this nigga this. This nigga fuck with a snitch. If I tell him this, he gonna tell a snitch. The snitch might tell a popo. Well, not might. He's gonna tell a popo.
Of course, that's why nobody wants to be affiliated.
No, you can't say that. No, that's not true.
For the most part,
I didn't see him in his video by himself.
To be affiliated with.
I didn't see him in his video by himself. Hold so on. There's individuals that want to be available. That you can't say that because he wasn't in a room by himself shooting the video.
No, he's not.
So then I disagree.
Most,
you can't say it.
Most people don't want to be a part of that. That's if they live the street life. If they're real street individuals, first and foremost, they don't want to be a part of that. But because nowadays, like you said, the game has changed. Nowadays, everything is about money. So these guys manipulate their way through with money because a person who never had nothing will take money from a person that they know did some foul shit to somebody else because it didn't have nothing to do with them. And their situation is their situation. So if Tekashi is coming through, he's paying for this. He's paying for this time. From people. It's not genuine. As far as what you're talking about with Jay, this is a whole different type of circuit. It's quiet because at the end of the day, he already knew what it was before he made a decision of putting Shorty in the position that she's in. He already knew what it was. He's a street dude, I'm pretty sure. But like I said, the money was probably worth more than that little bum ass situation for him. He looking at it like same way everybody else look at it. You didn't tell on me, you know what? It didn't have nothing to do with me, really. It is what it is. And that's how people looking at it. Right now, of course he got the money.
What you mean when you say Jay-Z with the shorty?
With the shorty. Because at the end of the day,
he didn't have to pick her. He had sisters and all that. You don't have to pick her.
Bro, it's things that we don't know. That's what I'm saying. We don't know the details.
I know that. Listen, I know before you got hired there,
he knew something.
That you was an informant.
I'm pretty sure before, he knew that. That's
listen,
what I said.
Listen, you wasn't an informant. You didn't become an informant while you was working with the team.
He ain't coming.
Right?
Yeah.
So you a street nigga. So if I'm hiring Trub, it's a street nigga. Trub, you're a street nigga. You hire me. What's your duties if you're hiring me? What is your duties if you're hiring me? If you're speaking
of background,
all right, okay.
Check
your
background.
Can't tell me a nigga who's worth the billy.
But that's what I'm
saying.
No.
We're gonna keep everything real.
It has to be money. that will make him compromise his own reputation for that.
No, because why do you need her? You could have ran it. No,
he's
not
never
making
worked
sense.
With any snitches
Listen,
before.
It's not making no
sense. Have we heard of anything prior to that?
Bro, he wasn't in the position prior to that. See, I take everything for what it is. He wasn't in that position prior to that.
What do you mean?
So he
He's
didn't
been
have
on top of the game for a while now.
On top of
bro.
The game and yeah. having
on top.
No. And being on top of the game and running your own company is something totally different, right? So now you own your own company, but you still want to be the artist. So you want somebody else to run it for you, right? Now you want somebody else to run it for you. You can pick a multiple of individuals. You cannot tell me that she's the best she's the best qualifier in the world. Someone who background is they snitched on a whole fucking cartel. You can't tell me that she's the best fit.
So
you cannot tell me that.
When you say that, I'm asking.
What Rockefeller? Let me ask you this: what Rockefeller artist is out right now? Or right now?
Rock Nation.
Not Rock Nation. Rock Nation. Rock Nation. Yes, yeah. Rock Nation. Tell me what Rock Nation artist, right? That is making millions and selling millions right now, and don't bring Megan Thee Stallion into it, because she's new.
Meek Mill.
You got to tell me. He's new. He's new to the family. Don't tell me that. Don't bring
Rock
up. Rock
Nation is a new brand. What do you?
But it's not new. It's not new as new Meek brand. Mill's. It's not new. It's been out way before Meek. Let me correct myself because you're getting me hype.
Yeah.
It hasn't been out way before Meek Mill's, but it's been out before Meek Mill's.
Yo Gotti is Rock Nation.
Before
Jim
Meek Mill's
is Rock Nation.
But those are all new and established individuals. So at
he
the end of the day,
it on his
so
own
what
first.
You telling me? So yeah. What are you telling me? What is she bringing to the table if you getting a whole bunch of veterans that have a clout already? What are you telling me?
Oh,
don't tell
know.
Me about Plaga that already sold personal. Platinum.
You can't
no.
ask me what his.
Bro,
what am I telling you?
I'm telling you that I thought it was
about money.
I just asked you a question.
What do you think it's about?
So you telling me?
What do you think it's about?
You're gonna
fuck
with an informant because of money?
Yeah, a lot of people do.
No, we're not talking about a lot of people. We took
Alpo's home.
No.
Why you think he's running around?
I hate when you switch the narrative.
I'm not switching the narrative.
You're switching the narrative because you said it's about money, right?
He's fucking with her for some money. They have a deal that we might not know about. It got to be for money. If he's willing to compromise who he is. You didn't hear me say that, bro? You can't.
I'm telling you. So if he's willing to compromise what he is, he compromised it. You don't know if it's for money.
I said,
and I don't know if it's for money, right?
And then what?
We don't know it's for money. So Hov is fucking with a certified snitch. Period. Ain't no then what? What you mean?
But nobody.
If I'm a billionaire.
So you saying because nobody's talking about it.
What did I say? I'm saying that people pick and choose. That's what I'm saying.
That's what I'm asking you.
People pick and choose. Because in the whole situation, he's fucking with a certified snitch. So you telling me it's okay if niggas fuck with Tekashi? Because he got money. It's a money deal. He's a certified snitch, but it's a money deal. That's what you said about Hov just now.
You said it's
about money. Hold on.
It's always going to be about the money
when
deal.
When y'all rewind the tape, he said that was a money deal.
Yes.
Okay.
I'm not.
You're a street nigga. Remember, this is also what he said before then. If you're a street nigger, you live by a code. If you're not a street nigger, you don't live by that code. So you're exempt. Hov, you're a billionaire. You did your research. You did a background check. We get background checks right now on any mediocre job we go to. So I know a billionaire is doing a thorough background check. He's a billionaire.
I don't disagree. I didn't disagree with any of that.
You feel me? So you did your background check and still accept it.
Yeah, nigga.
You can't tell me. You can't tell me you didn't do that. You can't tell me you didn't do that if you're worth billions. If I'm going to do a deal with Trub, I'm going to do a background on him to make sure that he ain't going to get me for what he's talking about.
Niggas do pick and choose.
You don't become a billionaire
by
being dumb.
Niggas do pick and choose.
So let me ask you this. If niggas pick and choose, is niggas that right? Because it's a code. That's what I'm saying overall.
No, that's not right.
That's what I'm saying overall.
It's not
niggas
right.
Do pick and choose. It's not right. It's a not code right. Is a code. So if niggas you're an individual and is a G and you respect the code goes for everybody.
That's why I don't say
there's no
nothing.
Exceptions.
I don't say I say my opinion.
So what I just asked the people, and I asked you, I'm asking you, and I asked the people, Tekashi snitch. Niggas know that, and we already knew that he was still going to be accepted. That's how I felt already, because I already know the game is in a different place. Mm-hmm. You feel me? Hove hires a certified snitch, paperwork out. Everything's out there for the public. Niggas know you've been getting grams,
but it's
and
not,
you've been
it's
doing
just
this
not
that,
publicized.
Right? So
that's the difference.
So it's out it's there not, though.
But now Tekashi is the one who brought
when,
that out.
When
there,
we say when we say
it wasn't
publicized, when we say no,
like niggas
you're right.
Knew
no.
Before
we're
that.
Not,
we didn't
listen,
know that. If
we're not
he didn't
talking
do
about
that, we wouldn't have known that.
But we're not talking about what he
if
did.
He did not do that.
Listen,
we wouldn't have known.
We're not talking about.
We're not looking for that.
We're not talking about what, but he did it, and we know.
But it's still not.
And the world knows. No, it's public size. It's public size. If Tekashi is doing a video.
No. Mainstream media.
Let me tell y'all something right now.
Tekashi's not mainstream.
Let me tell you something.
Media.
Mainstream media don't report snitches. You have to go on the internet for all of this. The mainstream media don't report what World Star reports.
They
so
did
we got,
report
so,
Tekashi
so,
snitches.
So because
and
that.
I don't report Jay-Z
because
snitches.
That was bodies and that was more current and that happened to
that's
two.
What I'm saying.
Niggas
it's not publicized
out there,
enough.
It's witnesses.
It's not
you feel
publicized.
Me? When she did her joint and she got caught up. When at that time when she snitched and got caught up in all that, that was publicized. That's why it was all public. It was publicized at that time. But if me as an individual, her as an individual, and she
know
did
if it
that,
wasn't for Tekashi.
And I'm and guess so, what? Guess what? And I totally agree. I don't care how I find out information. There's a lot of information that I didn't find out that I found out that I had to dig for. So I don't care. All I know is that I know it now. That's all I care. And then I have to think about the people that made the decision. If I know it now, you're not a poo-putt type of person. If you was a poo-putt type of person, I'll give you that. Like, nah, that nigga ain't do no research. That nigga just hide off a word of mouth.
No, he didn't
right?
hide off a word of
I
mouth.
I know that you're a billionaire, you're a millionaire, and you do your background. All millionaires, thousandaires do... Exactly. She got married to OG Juan. So we know your body. You're OG Juan's wife. What are you talking about? You always knew. So there's no excuse. Period. So all I'm saying is individuals, if you want to keep a code, if I say no smoking, that means no smoking for you, and you. If I say I don't fuck with snitches, if you snitch in any type of capacity or form, I don't fuck with you. That's it. You. So, like I said, people pick and choose. That's what I see in this 2020 because I didn't know that before Tekashi mentioned that because I wasn't looking for that in 2020. You feel me? Now, guess what? Guess what, though? I'm not even mad at him because guess what? He's on the vibe that we was on the vibe. We just talked about this off camera the other day. Back in the days when we used to get tapes, the first thing we do, we's grabbing the insert and we looking at the credits. We looking at who wrote it. We looking at who produced it. All of that. All of that was on the back of the joint. When you take your tape out and you go and you grab that shit out of there, you looking like, oh. Because back then, niggas would learn Jay-Z album the same day. Nothing else was getting played. Oh, Hov dropping tomorrow. You already know what that means. By tomorrow, if Hov dropped tonight, by tomorrow, we know all the songs word for word. Because we put it in, and we put it on repeat, and that was all that was rocking for the whole entire day. Facts. So, like I was telling you outside, rap now is pure entertainment. Meaning you could be a bird and talk about some gangster shit and niggas will love you if they feeling it. My era, you had to really be about what you was talking about. You had to be a lyricist. Certain things was required to even walk in the door, to even speak to A&R. That's how rough New York is. That's how rough New York is. If you wasn't even spitting hard body, you can, the A&R is like, stop. Stop. You good. You spit too, oh, no, no, no.
It was a standard. It was a standard.
New York created the standard. When we loosened up the standard, that's when shit changed. Let me ask you something, Plaga. How you feel about T.I. comments? Well, get into that.
Honestly, the South has always been a part of music for us, but New York music, New York is the mecca of hip hop. And of course, you know, we took it real serious. So we look at anybody who's coming half-assed. Like right now, my problem with the younger, you know, I groove to some of this shit, and this is why I have to say this. My most problem with the younger generation of music is they don't, it's entertainment for them. So it's so much entertainment for them that they don't even take what they say serious. They don't even take time to do what they do properly. They think that writing a song in 30 minutes is a good thing. Writing a song in 30 minutes is a good thing if it's a hit, if it's something timeless, because a lot of things are just for the moment. So as far as what he was talking about, New York, we created all this. So we look at everybody else as you got to have a standard, even with your shit coming from wherever it's coming from. It can't just be no ABC shit. But now the game is full of ABC shit, gimmicks. Most of this shit is gimmicks. These artists have no talent. They will only be here around for a short period of time. Yes, they will get money. They will look the image. They will look like they're getting all these, but they will not last the test of time because they're making music for the trends. You have to have love for what you're doing, when you're doing it. You have to have respect for the craft. These things just didn't happen.
You know what's so crazy?
To respect the craft.
I'm so happy that you said that.
They don't respect the craft at all. There's a lot of rappers. And that's what I don't like about now, most of all. Them not respecting the craft and the effort it takes to really be an artist.
So let me ask you something. Do you blame the artist or do you blame... The record execs or the record labels? Because
the record labels,
I think that us as rappers, guys as rappers, you know what it is. And I feel that the business side of it, once they seen that, oh, damn, Plaga can say A, B, C, D. Yeah, check it out. The Plaga can say A, B, C, and that shit's selling. Shit. Let me go sign Holla Holla. Because Holla Holla, he got that bullshit that motherfuckers like. So you got to understand, when it comes to the people that owns the record labels, they don't give a damn about lyrics, non-lyrics, if you the best in the hood, the best in your area. They don't give a fuck about none of that. What they give a fuck about is that, is you making the money or not? Is your shit selling or not? Could we do something with this or not? You understand what I'm saying? All that other shit is bullshit. It's bullshit. And to get back to what I was saying, niggas is going so hard over Tekashi. I'm so tired of it. I'm over it. Like, he been did what he did. It is what it is, and it's like, what is niggas talking about? Like, I could never fuck with a nigga like Tekashi. You understand what I'm saying? But individuals like him do exist in niggas' cipher right now. Minus the rainbow hair and minus all the bread and minus all of that. There are individuals in your hood, in your cipher, that are derelicts.
Yo.
That y'all niggas support. Period. Every hood got a Tekashi. How about that? Every hood got a Tekashi. A nigga that's really not gangster, really with the gangsters, but under pressure is going fold, for sure. Every hood got one. Right now, y'all all thinking like, damn, yeah, yo, this nigga, I know this nigga. Oh, damn, this nigga from my hood snitch. Oh, shit, damn, I heard this nigga, da, da, da. Yeah. Well, I don't understand why everyone is making the super big deal over Tekashi. Everything Tekashi said that he was going to do, he did when he came home. That's the crazy shit, ladies and gentlemen. That's the crazy shit. Said he was going to go number one without radio. So imagine if you grinding every day, you on YouTube, blah, 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 this, that, and the third. You keep it official. You out here keeping it 100. And here go this sucker-ass nigga. He get out of jail. He do a little video. This nigga get 3-4 million views in 48 hours. You trying to get 50,000. You trying to reach 50,000. Your shit been out for fucking 8 months. And it's hot. Not that it's whack. It's hot.
Yeah, that's the way struggling, the world.
And you struggling to get 50,000. This nigga didn't snitch. His whole court case. Everything is out for the public. Whatever. And he still's able to get
that's the goofy ass 2 million
views in 24 hours. So what I look like over exerting myself over what the game is, and what people have to understand, yeah, there's a lot of black rappers and the black entertainers, but they're not running the game. They're not running the game. You can be the face of the game, but you're not running the game. You're not running the game. You got to tell me what black person is cutting the checks for all these black rappers and black singers and black R&B artists and things of that nature.
It's the Jews.
No, they're in a system. They're with a label that's ran by non-black individuals. So what are you talking about? What are you talking about? That's the fucking problem.
It still doesn't mean that.
You feel me? You period.
It still doesn't mean that there's no rules. And when the OGs is not enforcing the rules,
niggas like Hov is quiet.
Let me get my moment.
He shut down T-Pain, but he ain't shut down Tekashi. Shut him down! If your word is law, shut him down.
His word.
You made niggas rock button ups. No, not you. I'm not saying you, bro. I'm not saying it's not personal. But when Hov said,
let me speak on it.
Rock button ups. What niggas was saying? When he was like, jerseys is corny. Rock button ups. You seen mad niggas?
Yeah, he don't have that type of influence. I'm not even. You know what though? You brought him up.
But niggas,
he's not even relevant to the young people.
I brought him up.
I brought him up about dealing with a rat. Yeah, that's what I'm saying.
So he works with a rat. He employs a rat. Yeah. He pays a rat. He gives a rat a fucking paycheck every fucking week.
Condemned.
So that's what I'm asking you.
He should be.
What are you talking about? We're talking about rats. Tekashi's a rat. Jay-Z has a female who runs Rock Nation. That's a rat. That's getting a paycheck from Jay-Z, which is not an ordinary nigga. He is a nigga that was in the game. Period. So he knows better.
He should be condemned just like all of them.
And that's all I'm saying. And that's all I'm saying.
I didn't disagree with you.
I didn't say you did. I never said you did.
You're not letting me speak on it, though. You keep talking about it, but you got to let me speak on it.
When you speaking upon what I'm not speaking about. That's what
I'm
saying.
No, so I'm telling you that still and all, none of that fucking shit matters.
How you saying it? How you saying you agree, but then you say it don't matter?
Yes, still and all. And none of it matters because these guys are obviously still doing what they're doing because of money.
But Jay-Z did what he did. So you telling me Jay-Z's a billionaire and he did what he did for money?
I'm saying right now, nobody's condemning him because it wasn't even publicized like that.
But it became publicized. So what are you doing after the fact? If you do a sneaky deal, right? If you do a sneaky deal.
Because we heard about it, it's publicized?
No, it was... They talked about it on the radio. Now, it's publicized.
He said, how long has she been in that position?
He has 2 million views in 24 hours.
How long
hours,
has
not
she been
hours.
Working that position?
That's how what I'm saying. Yo, Trump, you're position. Right. What you said, we didn't
how
know about it.
How long has she been holding
yo,
that
Trump,
position?
Yo, Trump, since they started, right? Since they started Roc Nation, he made her the fucking, what you call it, right? Exactly. So like you said, we wouldn't have known if it wasn't for him. I agree.
Known.
But now that we know, and Jay-Z... knows that we know.
Well, he's not out
right?
there trying to promote no music.
No,
like
but
that.
You made a
so
move.
Not,
I don't care about the music. We're talking about an individual. Fuck the music. Fuck the music. We're talking about character.
So what do you want? What do you want from that? That's what I'm asking you.
We already came to listen, bro.
I agree.
We already came. No,
that?
But you agree, and then you double talk after that. If
no,
you agree, listen.
Talk,
if you agree, I don't have no argument. But if you say but. And this
I'm
and
saying,
that.
But it's still, he's still going to continue doing what he's doing just like Tekashi.
No.
So what?
I'm saying that. So like I said at the beginning.
Because it's not even publicized like that. That's what I'm saying. Tekashi
I'm saying
is publicized
that,
more than
I'm
him.
Saying
so
that.
Going, like
I'm
now,
saying that if Tekashi is
nobody's
more,
even talking about it.
That.
Nobody's talking about Jay-Z being with a rat.
Because they don't want to.
Nobody talked about
because
it.
Because guess what? They
no
don't. No.
It.
Why? Because they don't want to.
All
what
these
thing?
Rappers
yo,
listen,
man. Listen, man. No, cut that shit out, man.
All them
cut that shit out, man. Because guess what? Guess what?
All
because Tekashi's a kid.
Yeah.
No. No. Jay-Z's a grown man with billions.
Yeah. So talk,
they
to,
biscuit
talk to the rappers. Talk to the rappers.
What are you talking about? You telling me that for
that
what? Why are you telling me that?
Not me.
Why are you telling? I'm not coming at you. I'm making a statement. It's not funny. I'm making a statement.
They
you talking about? Come
that.
On.
Not
what
me.
You talking about? I'm telling you that Jay-Z hired a known snitch, and that's a fact. And you know that, and you agree.
They didn't say nothing.
So what you saying?
I'm
what you saying?
Saying that
niggas ain't gonna say nothing to Jay-Z.
Say
I'm they saying that it's biased.
Tekashi,
I'm saying
yeah,
that
and
it's biased, and I'm not biased. That's what I'm saying.
Man.
That's what I'm saying. I'm saying that that's biased, and I'm not biased. So a snitch is a snitch. Period. I don't care if you snitch and you work for a billionaire. So now we ain't gonna talk about it. Oh, but Tekashi's a kid. And he snitched. We going to talk about it all day. We going to keep it in the news all day. We going to keep talking about how long Tekashi been home? He's off of house arrest now. And niggas are still talking about it all day.
I think the
but
video
guess what?
Ended it
Jay-Z, a known certified.
I think the video ended
a known
yesterday.
Certified OG. I'm disappointed in that hire.
I'm
me.
You. I'm disappointed.
Period. I'm disappointed. My kids don't listen to you.
He ain't gonna speak.
I listen to you.
Hov ain't speaking on that shit.
I listen to you. It's a fact, though.
He ain't gonna speak.
What we always say, certain things you gotta speak upon,
he
bro.
He ain't gonna speak. He's
what
gonna,
you, what
he
you say?
He above
reputation.
He above
reputation
that.
Means everything. Guard it with your life.
Facts. Guard it with
so
your
reputation is tainted.
Is everything.
It's been tainted from a lot of couple of dudes. But guess what? Since you got the bread, and I'm not here, I'm not trying to get at Hov. I'm just making the comparison
how
on
about,
individuals, how individuals, how the public,
how, about,
how individuals don't be real with themselves. I'm real with myself. I see what it is. Period. So I don't give a fuck if you had a billion and you hired a snitch. Nigga, that's some fuckboy shit. So if you didn't have billions and you hired a snitch, niggas would be getting at you all day? See, a lot of rappers don't get at Hov because he controls too much of the game. And he could stop their money. That's why niggas don't say nothing. Don't ever get it twisted. That's the only reason is because his influence on the culture is too heavy. Hove will shelf you. Period.
I don't disagree.
He will shelf you. You coming out, talk my name. Well, I know this guy. I've been with this guy for 20 years. You're a dub. Bye. That's all I'm saying. I love Hov. Hov is my guy. I love Hov. But at the end of the day, I'm telling you that rap has turned into entertainment. I cannot take it for what I took it for from before when I was growing up. It meant a whole lot different to me when I was growing up. It meant a lot. A lot of rappers, a lot of people were standing on their own too. I grew up in rap when the rap was on the come up. So it was a lot of hungry individuals. And it was real. So I appreciate that. This new gimmick shit, and that's why I say I understand it's entertainment. So I can't take nothing that an individual will say no more as their life. You understand what I'm saying? So it's all good with me. You want to do it? God. You want to put on a persona? God. You feel what I'm saying? We talk about this all the time. There's people that put on personas that who really not who they are. But if they make a hot song, it resonates with people, they're going to think that individual is like that. You understand what I'm saying? The internet, 30 seconds. Internet gave a lot of people a new life. You understand what I'm saying, Trump? The internet gave a lot of people new life. That's all I want to say. And I totally agree with you on what you were saying. You feel me? That's all. Period. You know what I mean? Like, if you out here in the world and you a thorough person, you have to keep your morals and perspectives thorough throughout. You can't pick and choose. You can't be like, well, he got a billion, so I'm not going to apply that to him. Oh, well, he got 1,000, so I could apply that to him. Well, he's 1,000 a year. I'm not going to do that to him. No, you don't do that. If you stand on something throughout.
And that's a fact. And on that note, ladies and gentlemen, thank y'all for tuning in.
Cheer!
To another episode of Words with Poodie and Plaga. Sometimes you.
And.
You.
And.
You.
And.
We catch y'all next week.
Yo, stay tuned next week, man. Stay tuned. Hot and heavy, man. S Street Media. Make sure y'all check us out. S Street Media. Check us out. YouTube. Check us out, man. I'm telling you, check us out, man. We have a lot of podcasts going
artists
on here, man.
Send that music
a lot of things
in.
Going on here, man.
All
check us out, man.
Artists, you feel send me? That music
and if you want to be part of the fam, holla at Math. You dig? Holla at Math at S Street Media on IG. DM him. You dig?